My full name is Yemi Osunkoya, and my title is the designer behind the label Kosibah. My family background is of Nigerian descent. So I was raised in Nigeria in a university campus, a place called Ibadan. One out of four brothers, and had a relatively happy childhood. I was educated partly in Nigeria, and also I studied fashion design here in the UK, and I'm presently based in Camden, London. In terms of having business experience before I started, the answer is I had none, because I finished my fashion course during the early 90s when there was a recession in the UK, and after spending a year of sending out letters to designers, I didn't get any positive response, so I decided to set up on my own. But what I did was, because the government was encouraging people to be self-employed, I went on a government-run 6-week course on marketing, taxation, PR, administration, the business of, you know, running a label. And I did that, and I chose a specific date, wrote to the tax office, did everything, and bought and started. So I've never actually worked for anyone before.
Where do I begin to tell the story of how great love can be? The sweet love story that is older than the sea. The simple truth about the love he brings to me. Where do I start?
Setting up my business was, I was quite naive. I was very young. I just decided it was something I needed to do. I got some funding from my mother. I found a very small premises which I absolutely loved, and just set about getting clients. I knew very early on that the best way to do it was through exposure in magazines, and I learned that the magazines need to fill in their pages with stuff. So we, you know, they need us in terms of designers as much as we need them in terms of public publicity. So I got myself into quite a lot of magazines at a very early stage, and bit by bit by bit, you know, I just added to my client list. One of the funny stories I can think of from the early days of starting up was my first exhibition. And when I think back, I actually cringe with embarrassment, because I had a stand, and I took photographs that were quite loose. They weren't in an album, they weren't, you know, in any sort of format, and I just laid them out on the table. I didn't have anything to take people's details. It was all, you know, when it was funny, you know, when I think back it's sort of funny, but I sort of learned from it. That's one standout moment from the early times. My personal strength as a designer, I would say, is the ability to understand the shape of a woman, because I do women's wear, and also the ability to almost by osmosis take in what a client would want, you know, would want in terms of a dress that would tick all the boxes, and also to draw. That's one of my strengths, because if you are doing couture and there's a matter of trust there, if you're able to sketch a design that looks very realistic and the client can imagine themselves in it, or to look at the garment and see this looks like a real dress, that's a real strength as a designer. Also, I have a drive that just enables me to strive on. I would say my weaknesses would be in terms of admin, keeping on top of paperwork, the sort of boring aspects of it, but I'm aware it has to be done, but that would be my weak part. I do not have a mentor as such, but I'm inspired, or I was inspired in the past and continue to be inspired by the designer Bruce Oldfield. I knew about Bruce Oldfield when I was very young, and as a black man, I could identify with him, and especially a black man that grew up in, you know, the circumstances which he did in a children's home. Not that I did, but my attitude was that if he could rise to the heights he's risen to, then anybody can, really. And he continues to be relevant, he continues to improve on his work, which is what something I try to do. I've been in business for 22 years, but I do not rest on my laurels. I continue to try to do better, stay relevant, be fresh, and, you know, I sort of get my inspiration from the soul world.
Where you can stay forever, you can be so that it will only get better. You and me together through the days and nights. I don't worry, cause everything's gonna be alright. People keep talking, they can say what they like, but all I know is everything's gonna be alright.
What I love most about what I do is the reaction I get when I've created a dress for a client that gets the look in the face of a client when they put on my dress and they're seeing a shape they just did not envisage they would ever have as a result of what I have done. That gives me the most satisfaction, and especially during the event itself, the reaction people give to the person wearing my dress is normally very complimentary, because, you know, they look and feel their very best. My advice for budding designers is you have to realize that fashion is a business. It's more than just drawing and then it's all done. There's a lot of hard work that goes behind it. You have to make sure your product is perfect, or as perfect as you can make it. So it's not just what's happening on the outside. People must be able to look inside your garment, and it should all be nicely finished. You should always be able to wear your dress inside out. You should get used to the idea of, you know, marketing yourself, establishing a brand, being able to talk about your designs, being able to, you know, portray yourself in a way that would reflect very well on your brand, and also keeping fresh with your ideas. And but I guess the most important thing is the business aspect of it, because no matter how brilliant you are, if you don't run your business successfully, it will fail. What makes a brand successful are all the elements of a successful business being sort of upright at the same time. So good marketing, a good product, the brand has to be strong. Good marketing, people have to know about what you are doing, otherwise, you know, there's no point. At the moment, good presence in social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and the ability to sell your products, because at the end of the day, if nobody buys it, there's no point. In terms of changing the way Nigerian fashion is presented, I think we are doing all the right things at the moment. There's always room for improvement in everything, but I think the way things are at the moment is on the right track. Hi, my name is Yemi Osunkoya, the designer behind the Kosibah label, and you're watching Spice TV.